الحمد لله الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. Dear brothers and sisters everywhere and all over the world, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. One has to realize that loving Allah is a half of faith, half of iman. That's why one who doesn't love Allah, he doesn't have any faith. Allah the Almighty says in Surah Al-Ma'idah, Ayah number 54, يُحِبُّهُمْ وَيُحِبُّونَ. A people he will love and they will love him. And in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 165, Allah the Almighty says, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَشَدُّ حُبًّا لِلَّهِ. But those who believe are stronger in love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's how the Sahaba, the companions, the noble companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, that's how they were raised to a lofty position with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that's how they gained His pleasure. Dear brothers and sisters, you have to love Allah. You have to love Allah as He made the whole universe serve you and attend to your needs. You have to love Him for the countless bounties He bestowed upon you, and for the countless graces He has bestowed and blessed you with. You have to love Allah for the guidance that He gave you through His Messenger and the Quran. However, what is more important is that Allah the Almighty loves you. If you love Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this is the principle. And you have to do this. You have to do this as you are nothing but one of His countless signs and miracles. Your existence belongs to Him and depends on Him. Glory be His. Your guidance and hidayah come from Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. However, what is still needed is that Allah the Almighty loves you. But how to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Allah the Almighty mentions in the Quran 8 ayahs containing 8 traits. These traits show who are the ones that are loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today, inshallah, we're going to deal with just one trait, a single one of these ayahs. If you want to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to be from the muhsineen, the doers of good. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, verse number 195, وَأَحْسِنُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ يُحِبُّ الْمُحْسِنِينَ. And do good, indeed Allah loves the doers of good, the muhsineen, the doers of good. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ كَتَبَ الْإِحْسَانَ عَلَى كُلِّ شَيْءٍ. And this is combined in Sahih Muslim. Verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, verily Allah has prescribed ihsan, perfection and proficiency in all things. Al-ihsan is a comprehensive term that encompasses nearly everything. If you study hard and you submit your assignments on time, this is ihsan. If you do your job well, this is ihsan. If you help others, this is ihsan. If you remove a harmful object from the road, this is ihsan. If you treat your wife and children well, this is ihsan. If you treat your neighbors well, this is ihsan. If you treat your siblings well, this is ihsan. If you enjoin what is good and forbid what is evil, this is ihsan. If you reconcile between two fighting persons or two spouses, this is ihsan. If you treat animals well, this is ihsan. You have to show mercy to everyone and to everything. You have to be kind to everyone. This is what's meant to be a muhsin. It's to perfect your job, to treat your neighbors well, and to keep your word, to fulfill your promises. So, if you want to be loved by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to be a doer of good. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love you. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam defined al-ihsan in the hadith of Jibril, when Sayyidina Jibril asked him about the meaning of Islam and about the meaning of iman and about the meaning of ihsan, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, al-ihsan huwa an ta'buda Allah ka'annaka tarah fa in lam takun tarahu fa innahu yarak. Ihsan is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if you are seeing Him, as if you see Him. And if you do not reach the state of that, this state of devotion, so you have to take it for granted that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sees you all the time and in all conditions and in all circumstances. If you become a muhsin, you will act as a perfect da'iyah. And this is what happened. This is what happened in Southeast Asia. Yemeni merchants who visited those lands, those territories, and because of the good treatment they showed to the people, the natives of these countries, and the good treatment that they conducted among themselves, those people who used to worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they became fascinated with the Muslims, and they became fascinated with their behavior and their conduct, and they started to inquire about the background, the cultural background and the religious background of those people. And when they knew that all that stemmed from Islam and the faith of Islam, they embraced Islam in millions. There is a maxim that is always attributed to Sayyidina Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu anhu, which says, حَالُ رَجُلٍ فِي أَلْفِ رَجُلٍ خَيْرٌ مِنْ قَوْلِ أَلْفِ رَجُلٍ فِي رَجُلٍ. The individual action of a man will do more than the saying of 1,000 men. And as you all know, actions speak louder than words. If you want to understand the meaning of a concept in the Quran, you have to consult the Quran itself. Go to the Quran and look up the word al-muhsinin or al-muhsinun, and you're gonna find it occurring in different locations, like in Surah Al-Dhariyat and in Surah Luqman. From Surah Al-Dhariyat, for example, Allah the Almighty says, "Inna al-muttaqin fi jannatin wa uyun." Indeed, the righteous will be among gardens and springs. آخذين ما آتاهم ربهم إنهم كانوا قبل ذلك محسنين. Accepting what their Lord has given them. Indeed, they were before that doers of good. But what are the signs? What are the signs of being محسنين? What made them محسنين in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The Quran teaches us and the Quran educates us and enlightens us about this. The Quran says, and here are some of their descriptions. كانوا قليلا من الليل ما يهجعون. They used to sleep but little of the night. They used to stay most of the night performing the late night prayer, reciting the Quran and remembering Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and asking him for forgiveness. وبالأسحار هم يستغفرون. And in the hours before dawn they would ask forgiveness. And when the last part of the night, which is called as-sudus, when it befalls them, they start to seek forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala as if they have been committing, sins throughout the night. And another description of those people, al-muhsinin, is that وَفِي أَمْوَالِهِمْ حَقٌّ لِلسَّائِلِ وَالْمَحْرُومِ. And from their properties was given the right of the needy petitioner and the deprived. They knew that they have to give out of their properties to the needy and to those who are deprived, to those who ask for financial help, and for those who are shy, to ask help from others. Finally, one has to be righteous and a doer of good, regardless of his condition, be it good or bad. This is learned from Prophet Yusuf sallallahu alayhi wasallam, who was described as being one of the doers of good while he was in the palace. After his appointment as a prime minister of Egypt, or the prime minister of Egypt, and he was described as a muhsin, or from among the muhsineen, the doers of good, when he was unjustly imprisoned. Neither fortune nor misfortune changed him. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from among the muhsineen and to admit us, every one of us, to his jannah. Ameen, ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.